You know, it's crazy that you talk about Dan Quinn. That takes us into one of our next topics, man. We have a new regime in Atlanta. We got Terry Fontenot as our GM, Arthur Smith as our head coach. How are you feeling today as a Falcons fan?
So initially, I wasn't pumped about the hires, honestly, initially. After kind of looking at it a little bit more, I see what type of dynamic and what type of team they're really trying to build. And so my thought is this, depending on, of course, what they do with that fourth pick, bringing him in, you look at a team that he comes from, and granted, the personnel is Derrick Henry, right? You know, best running back in the NFL, power running, play action passing. I liked the hire of Arthur Smith after I looked at it even more. And I'll say this is why. Arthur Smith's dad is the founder of FedEx, which makes his dad a billionaire, which makes him a de facto billionaire. Because if his dad's a billionaire, he's a fucking billionaire. And so the reality is this. This is a guy that's not doing this for a paycheck.
Mm-hmm.
He's invested in coaching. And I'm sure just like with anyone who has a dad, like, you know, that's or a mom, you know, a parent, a guardian that has done great things. You don't want to be known for what your parents are. You want to have your own thing. And for him, coaching is his thing. He probably loves football. He's a football guy. He's done his time. He got his chance to be the OC. Think about it. Matt LaFleur was the OC before he was the OC. And Matt LaFleur's offense wasn't that great. He had Derrick Henry too. And granted, Derrick Henry was probably in what, year three maybe? So I guess he was a little bit younger. But still, that offense was vanilla at best. You know, they were ranked 18th, you know, 19-20. They were in that range of being ranked with Matt LaFleur, who's done a terrific job with the Packers. You get this guy. The Titans have had a top five offense the past 2 years. They're number one in red zone scoring. And red zone efficiency. That is the biggest issue that the Falcons face. When they get in the red zone, they don't score. They don't put up touchdowns. They settle for field goals. And that's been a big issue. And so, to me, if he can bring his scheme in and we can get the right running game, because that's going to be key in this, if he's going to run the same philosophy, you know, which is power run, play action pass, I can see how this would work out beautifully. In reality, they got to get the right running back, though. And I know that even with that running game, you have to have a good old line. And so that's the task I think that the new regime is going to have to deal with, man. What direction do we really want to go in with this team? Is it time to move on from Matt Ryan? Is it time to have a new face of the franchise? Can we still win it all with these guys that we have? And just retool around them. Because you hear that word so much, retool. And it seems like, you know, how often does that work? How often does retooling work for teams that feel like they've missed their championship window?
So I'm kind of where you are. And I said on this podcast 2 weeks ago that Adam Gase was going to get Arthur Smith a job that he wasn't ready for. And it was because Tannehill was so bad under Gase, and Gase is such a terrible coach that we're now seeing that Tannehill becoming a better quarterback in the league, and we don't even want to accept it because of what he was with Gase, was going to make people believe that Arthur Smith had a lot to do with this. And I was like, maybe it's just the stench of Gase being off of him. But then I did some homework. You know, I listened to the press conferences. I actually looked at some numbers, and it's not a sexy hire, but it makes perfect sense for what the Falcons need. As far as we've been terrible in the trenches, and that's what he does. He's an offensive line guy. That's where he cut his teeth at. So bringing a guy who's good with the offensive line, also was able to deal with injuries to his offensive line in Tennessee, and still be productive within the red zone. We could not score in the red zone. We haven't been able to score in the red zone since Kyle.
Well, obviously, I guess Shanahan, obviously, if you that one outlier year, we were really good in the red zone. But hell, we had a ton of it. What you got drinking over there? Making that face.
I grabbed the wrong cup.
But, you know, outside of that one outlier year, you know, being the Super Bowl year where, of course, we were just scoring from everywhere, explosive plays within the 20, you know, within the 50, whatever. We were scoring from pretty much everywhere. Outside of that year, you haven't had a red zone presence where you had a guy that just really punched it in since Michael Turner. You know, Patrick DeMarco being fullback, like, you know, we haven't had it. And so it just, I think that's one of the things that he definitely brings to the table. But I agree with you, obviously, like, you know, it wasn't a sexy hire. Everybody's like, who the fuck is that? Like, you know, I mean, that's really what you're thinking to yourself. Who the fuck is that? Hell, the last time I watched the Tennessee Titans play, they scored 10 points in the playoffs at home.